तेजश्री कुसबे, लेक्चरर फ्रॉम प्रवीण पाटिल पॉलिटेक्निक भाईंदर। टुडेज टॉपिक इज मेजरमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक पावर पार्ट वन। लर्निंग आउटकम्स। एट द एंड ऑफ द वीडियो यू विल लर्न अबाउट व्हाट इज पावर, डायनामोमीटर टाइप वाट मीटर, एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रो डायनामोमीटर टाइप वाट मीटर। कंसेप्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक पावर। Power can be defined as the time rate of energy transfer or energy dissipation in a load. Power is the rate of using or supplying energy. The rate at which work is done to maintain an electric current in a circuit is termed as electric power. Electric power is measured in watts. The kilowatt is a commonly used unit where 1 kilowatt is equal to 1000 watts. Electric power formula. Normally, electric power is useful making a lamp light or a motor turn. Electric power equals the product of the current I and the potential difference V. So, power is the product of current and voltage, where power is denoted by P, current with I, and voltage with V. So, it becomes P is equal to I into V. And unit of the power is watt, unit of current is ampere, and unit of voltage is volt. So P is equal to I into V is the formula of power. Next is the balance and unbalanced load. When all the impedances of three phases are equal in magnitude and of same nature, then load is said to be balanced. In such case, the current drawn by all phases and phase voltages are equal in magnitude and displaced in space by 120 degree with respect to each other. This is the diagram for balance load. In this, you can see there are three loads, which is denoted by Z1, Z2 and Z3. And if the load is balanced, that is Z1, Z2 and Z3 are of same nature. You can say these three are of resistive type or inductive type or capacitive type. Then you can say this is the balance load. So balance load, in balance load you can say Z1 is equal to Z2 is equal to Z3. And this is the first diagram is for Y connection and next diagram is for delta connection. So delta connection, for both system, star as well as delta, balance load, in balance load Z1 is equal to Z2 is equal to Z3. And for unbalanced load, each phase load may not be the same. Unbalanced load. When all the impedances of three phases are not equal in magnitude and of different nature, then load is said to be unbalanced. In such cases, the phase currents and voltages differ in magnitude with respect to each other and are not displaced in space by 120 degree with respect to each other. So in unbalanced load, the impedances, that is Z1, Z2 and Z3, are not equal in magnitude and of different nature, means Z1 you can say resistive, Z2 inductive and Z3 capacitive, then that load may be termed as unbalanced load. This is the diagram for unbalanced load. In this you can see the Z1 is resistive in nature, Z2 is capacitive and Z3 is inductive in nature. Then this type of load is known as unbalanced load, and in this unbalanced load the current in each phase is different. Next is watt meter terminals. A watt meter has two coils, namely the current coil CC and the voltage coil. Each coil having two terminals makes the watt meter a four terminal instrument, and these terminals are named as mains, that is M, load L, common C and voltage V. So this is the symbol of wattmeter. In this you can see M and L are the terminals of CC, that is current coil, and C and V are the terminals of voltage coil. So there are four terminals each of current coil and voltage coil. Current coil has two terminals, M and L, and voltage coil has two terminals, C and V. So there are four terminals of wattmeter, M, L, C, V. This electrodynamometer type wattmeter. Electrodynamometer type wattmeter is an instrument whose working is related to the reaction between magnetic fields of the fixed coil and moving coil, which is connected across the voltage. Electrodynamometer wattmeters are similar to the electrodynamometer ammeters and voltmeters. These are mainly used to measure power. This is the diagram of dynamometer type wattmeter. In this you can see there are two coils. One is fixed coil and another is moving coil. And in this, fixed coil is divided in two parts, that is in two halves, one at another end, and in the middle of this fixed coil there is a moving coil which is termed as voltage coil, and fixed coil are termed as current coil. As you know, wattmeter has two coils, current coil and pressure coil or voltage coil. So fixed coil is termed as current coil and moving coil is termed as voltage coil. And this is the actual image of wattmeter. In this also you can see there are two fixed coils, that is termed as current coil in this diagram. And in the middle you can see there is a moving coil which is named as voltage coil. And control spinning is for controlling purpose, and pointer and scale. So this is the actual image of wattmeter, and this is the diagram of wattmeter. In this also you can see there are fixed coils, and in the center you can see there is a moving coil. In this image also you can see there are two current coils, and in the middle you can see there is a voltage coil or moving coil. So construction, an electrodynamic type instrument consists of two fixed coil and moving coil, control spring, damping device and magnetic shielding arrangement. We will discuss each of them one by one. Fixed coil. Fixed coil is provided for the sake of production of magnetic field. This fixed coil is divided into two sections so that a uniform magnetic field may be achieved at the center. Further, splitting a fixed coil in two sections facilitates passage of instrument's moving shaft. So there is only one fixed coil which is split in two halves, one at other end, and in the middle of fixed coil, moving coil is placed. Next is moving coil. A moving coil serves the purpose of converting the actuating quantity into readable value on the scale. It is generally wound on a non-magnetic metallic former. Metallic former shall never be used as it will lead eddy current generation due to changing flux. This eddy current will introduce inaccuracy as eddy current damping is not used in electrodynamic instrument. So this is the main part of dynamometer type wattmeter. By moving coil, this moving coil is connected to the pointer. So when the moving coil moves, then the pointer gets deflected and you can read the reading on the wattmeter. Next is damping. Air friction damping is employed in electrodynamic type instrument. To provide air friction damping, a pair of aluminium vane is attached to the spindle at the bottom. दिस वेन्स मूव इन अ सेक्टर शेप चेम्बर. सो इन दिस फॉर डैम्पिंग पर्पस एयर फ्रिक्शन डैम्पिंग मेथड इज यूज. नेक्स्ट इज शील्डिंग. द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इन एरोडायनामिक टाइप इंस्ट्रूमेंट इज वेरी वीक ऑफ द ऑर्डर ऑफ 0.005 टू 0.006 वेबर पर मीटर स्क्वायर. Therefore, it becomes very important to protect the instrument from the effect of external magnetic field. To provide magnetic shielding, normally electrodynamic type instrument is enclosed in high permeability alloy. So, in this wattmeter, shielding is very necessary as the magnetic field of this instrument is very weak and it can be affected by the external magnetic field, or you can say stray magnetic field, and it may produce error. And to reduce that error, you have to use shield which avoid the effect of external magnetic field. Next is working principle. The electrodynamometer type wattmeter working principle is very simple and easy. It is based on the theory of current carrying conductor experiences a magnetic force when it is placed in a magnetic field. Hence, there will be a deflection of pointer that took place due to the mechanical force. It contains two coils, such as fixed coil, which is termed as current coil, and moving coil, which is, you can say, pressure coil or voltage coil. So the working principle of this wattmeter is based on theory that is current carrying conductor experience a magnetic force when it is placed in a magnetic field, which is the principle of this electrodynamometer type wattmeter. The fixed coil is used to carry the current and connected in series with the load in any circuit. The moving coil carries the current directly proportional to the voltage and connected across the voltage. The value of current limited to a minimum value due to large non-inductive resistance connected in series. So fixed coils also carry the current and they are connected in series with the load, and fixed coil are termed as current coil. And moving coil also carry current which is directly proportional to the voltage. Next is advantages. So first advantage is it is free from hysteresis and eddy current losses. Second, without modification it can be used for AC and DC. Third is highly accurate. Fourth is both active and reactive power can be measured by different. So you can also measure active and reactive power by this wattmeter. Next is disadvantages. First is cost is more. Second, as iron core is not used, magnetic flux is weak. So more number of turns are required to produce desired magnetic field. Third is torque to weight ratio is small. Fourth, operate on weak magnetic field due to cores not used. Fifth, it needs magnetic shielding. So these are the advantages of electrodynamometer type wattmeter. Next is the torque equation. The instantaneous torque of an electrodynamometer instrument is given by Ti is equal to I1 I2 dm upon d theta, where I1 and I2 are instantaneous values of currents in two coils. As you know, there are two coils, fixed coil and moving coil, and I1 and I2 are the values of current coil and voltage coil. In this diagram you can see there is a current coil which carry current which is denoted by IC, and the pressure coil which carries the current which is denoted by IP. Let V and I be the RMS values of voltage and current being measured, the instantaneous value of the voltage across the pressure coil circuit, V is equal to root 2 V sin omega t. If the pressure coil circuit has a very high resistance, it can be termed as purely resistive. Therefore, current Ip in the pressure coil is in phase with the voltage and its instantaneous value is given by Ip is equal to V upon Ip is equal to root 2 V upon Rp sin omega t. And in this, again V upon Rp is replaced by Ip. So the final equation is root 2 Ip sin omega t, where Ip is equal to Vp upon Rp, which is RMS value of current in pressure coil circuit, and Rp is resistance of pressure coil circuit. If the current in the current coil lags the voltage in phase by an angle, then instantaneous value of current through current coil is Ip is equal to root 2 I sin omega t minus theta. So when this current coil lags the voltage by some angle theta, then the value of that current coil is Ip is equal to root 2 I sin in bracket omega t minus theta. Instantaneous torque, which is given by Ti, is equal to I1 I2 into dm by d theta. And now we have values of I1 and I2. So this instantaneous torque becomes root 2 Ip sin omega t into root 2 I sin omega t minus theta dm upon d theta, which is equal to 2 Ip into I sin omega t sin omega t minus theta dm by d theta is equal to Ip into I in bracket cos theta minus cos in bracket 2 omega t minus theta bracket complete dm by d theta. So in this instantaneous torque, value of Ip is root 2 Ip sin omega t, and value of Ic is root 2 I sin omega t minus theta. So put these values in this equation, you get the equation root 2 into root 2, it becomes 2. So 2 into Ip into I sin omega t into sin omega t minus theta dm by d theta. And next is the formula for sin A into sin B, which is used in this equation. Then the equation becomes Ip into I cos theta minus cos 2 omega t minus theta dm by d theta. It is clear from above that there is a component of power which varies as twice the frequency of current and voltage. Average deflecting torque is given by Td is equal to 1 upon T integration of 0 to T Ti d omega t is equal to 1 upon T integration of 0 to T put the value of Ti, which becomes Ip into I cos phi minus cos 2 omega t minus phi dm by d theta d omega t is equal to Ip into I cos phi dm by d theta. They solve the integration and then value becomes Ip into I cos phi dm by d theta is equal to V into I upon Rp cos phi dm by d theta. As you know, V upon Rp is the value of Ip, and put this value of Ip, then the final equation becomes V into I upon Rp cos phi dm by d theta. Next, controlling torque exerted by springs as for to produce controlling torque. In dynamometer type watt meter also they use springs for that purpose. And when you use spring, then the value of controlling torque becomes K theta. So TC is equal to K theta as springs are used, where K is equal to spring constant and theta is equal to final steady deflection. Since the moving system of the electrodynamometer type wattmeter cannot follow the rapid variations in torque, the torque has a double frequency component. It will take a position at which the average deflection torque is equal to the restoring torque of the spring. So in this also stable state occurs when deflecting torque is equal to controlling torque. TC is equal to TD. At balance position, K theta is equal to IP into I cos phi dm by d theta, or deflection theta is equal to IP into I cos phi dm by d theta upon K is equal to, the value of IP is V upon RP. Put this value, then equation becomes V into I cos phi upon RP into K dm by d theta. Next, all these values are termed as constant K1. Then the final equations become K1 is into VI cos phi into dm by d theta is equal to K1 dm by d theta into P. As you know, power is denoted by VI cos phi, active power. So VI cos phi is replaced by P. So final equation becomes K1 dm by d theta into P, where P is power being measured, is equal to VI cos phi and K1 is equal to 1 upon RPK. Next is multiplying factor. So watt meter is constructed such that it read only power on a single scale. Only single scale will available to read the measured power. In order to take the accurate reading, just we measure the reading and we will multiply along with factor called multiplication factor. That's depend on which voltage knob we connected and also the current. So multiplication factor can be determined by multiplication factor is equal to voltage range into current range into power factor divided by maximum scale deflection. So multiplying factor is very important in watt meter reading. If multiplying factor is not multiplied to watt meter reading, then you get the wrong reading. So as you can select any voltage range and current range, and multiplying factor can change according to voltage range you select or current range you selected. So multiplying factor is very important in while taking watt meter reading or power. Next are the numericals of watt meter multiplying factor. A single phase watt meter rated for 500 volt 10 ampere has full scale deflection of 1250 watt. What is the multiplying factor of watt meter? So voltmeter range is 500 volt, current range is 10 ampere, then you can derive multiplying factor, which is voltage range into current range divided by full scale deflections. The voltage range is 500, current range is 10 ampere. So 500 into 10 upon full scale deflection is 1250 watt. So 500 into 10 upon 1250 it becomes 5000 divided by 1250. So multiplying factor becomes 4. So answer is 4 for this numerical. Next is, a watt meter has a voltage range of 300 volt and current range of 10 ampere. If the FSD, that is full scale deflection of meter, is 1500 watt, then calculate the multiplying factor of meter. So formula for multiplying factor is voltage range into current range upon full scale deflection. And in this numerical, voltage range is 300 volt, current range is 10 ampere, and full scale deflection is 1500 watt. So put these values in the equation, you will get the answer 2. So 300 into 10 upon 1500 is equal to 2. Next numerical is, watt meter is rated for 600 volt 5 upon 10 ampere with FSD of 1500 watt. The reading obtained when used on 10 ampere range is 1000 watt. Find out the actual power consumed in load. So in this numerical, current range is 10 ampere, voltage range 600 volt, full scale deflection 1500 watt, given reading is 1000 watt, multiplying factor formula is current range into voltage range upon full scale deflection. So current range is 10, voltage range 600, full scale deflection 1500 watt. So put these values in equation, you get answer 4. So multiplying factor is 4. Next, power consumed by load is equal to multiplying factor into watt meter reading. So multiplying factor is 4, watt meter reading given in this numerical is 1000. So 4 into 1000, final answer becomes 4000 watts.